The Northern Lights are a seemingly magical display where ribbons of bright colors ripple through the night sky. Their scientific name is Aurora Borealis. But have you ever wondered what causes them? It all has to do with energy. Energy is basically the ability to move things. That movement could be as big as a car driving across the country, or as small as a vibration of a subatomic particle. Energy is everywhere, but the total amount of energy in the universe never changes. Instead, it transfers. It changes from one form, like chemical energy in food, to another, like the kinetic energy of you running around on the playground. The Northern Lights are caused by the transfer of energy through space towards the Earth's atmosphere. So all aboard, let's look at each step along the way. First off, energy comes from outer space in the form of a bunch of electrically charged particles, called plasma. The sun is constantly emitting a stream of plasma, which we call the solar wind. The solar wind travels through space until it reaches the Earth. Most of the solar wind is deflected by the Earth's magnetic field. This is basically a force field that's generated by the movement of molten metals in the Earth's core. Without this force field, the blast of the solar wind would damage living things and technological systems, like our electrical grid. But not all of the particles from space get deflected. Some of them get trapped in the magnetic field and then funneled into one of these two areas. One near the magnetic North Pole, and one near the magnetic South Pole. There, they collide with particles in Earth's atmosphere and transfer energy to them. These newly excited particles in our atmosphere can't stay in that energized state for long. So, they release the extra energy as light particles called photons, which create the patterns we call the aurora. Depending on where the particles are in the atmosphere, they create different colors of light. Oxygen particles high in the atmosphere emit red light, while oxygen particles lower down emit green light. Nitrogen particles often produce shades of blue and purple. Over time, scientists have gotten pretty good at predicting when and where we'll be able to catch the Northern Lights. But other mysteries remain, including why they form such distinctive, shimmering curtains. For more extreme nature stories, check out cbckidsnews.ca.